Another important type of calculation that we'll do in this chapter is called percent yield. The easiest way, I think, to explain percent yield would be to kind of relate it to a test percentage. So when you take a test, it's important to know how well it is that you're doing, and we often do this in the form of a percentage. Well, just like that test percentage, percent yield is the same thing for a chemical reaction. So it's a way of figuring out how well we did on our chemical reaction. Now, the way you calculate a test percentage is pretty simple, and it's pretty intuitive now that you've probably done it through all of these different years. You take the points that you earned, you divide it by the total value or the total number of points on that test, multiply it times 100. Well, we're going to do the same thing essentially for a chemical reaction. It's just that instead of points earning, we're earning grams. So the amount that you actually make in the lab is a lot like the points that you earn, and we call that the actual yield. Now, the points that the test is worth is like how you can predict perfectly with no mistakes happens on paper. It's a theoretical yield, the amount that you should probably be able to make in a perfect world. You find a theoretical yield at the end of a stoichiometry problem. It's the answer to your stoichiometry problem. So again, the amount that you make in lab divided by the amount that you should make on paper times 100 is what we call a percent yield. And I want to make sure that you have an example so you can see this in action. So back to our sodium and chlorine example. We've already finished up our stoichiometry problem. Our theoretical yield is 63.5 grams. That's in a perfect world, nothing goes wrong, on paper, this is the amount that I should make. Well, here's the add-on to the problem. What is the percent yield of the reaction if the actual yield of sodium chloride is 55.2? Now, the actual yield is the amount that you actually made in the lab room. So it sounds like we're ready for a test percentage. So again, back to our equation, actual divided by theoretical times 100. Don't forget the actual yield is the 55.2, the amount that you make in lab, and the theoretical yield is the 63.5, the amount that you can make on paper, the answer to the stoichiometry problem. So we'll plug and chug our numbers into our calculation, and we should be able to get our final answer at 86.9%.